Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful poster for Star Wars The Force Awakens Episode 7. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create a background filled with stars, galaxies, and the basic resistance insignia. And in part two, we'll add dimension to the insignia, add text, and dramatic lighting. Before we begin, you can get the most current version of Photoshop and Lightroom and 20 gigabytes of cloud storage all together for only $7.99 per month. Click the link in my video's description to get the discount. I provided a Photoshop file for you to download so you can follow along. It includes the Rebel Resistance emblem and a brushed steel texture. With the emblem hidden, make the texture active and go to Filter, Distort, and Polar Coordinates. Tick Rectangular to Polar and click OK. To help blend in the top center, open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a selection over it approximately this wide. Go to Edit and Fill. Choose Content Aware and click OK. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Ctrl click or Command click on the emblem to make a selection of its shape. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Unlock the background and press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete everything outside the selection, then deselect it. Let's add more contrast to our emblem. Press Ctrl or Command L to open levels. In the input black field, type in 48, and in the input white field, type in 230. Then click OK. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N. Make its width 672 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the small box to open the color picker and pick black. Then click OK on both windows. Make three copies of the background by pressing Ctrl or Command J three times. Name the top layer Large Stars, the one under it Stars, and the next layer Border. Hide the top layer and make the Stars layer active. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 30%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 0.3 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. In the Input Black field, type in 100, and in the input white field, type in 200. Then click OK. Make the Large Stars layer visible and active. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. This time, make the amount 100% and click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 1 pixel, press Enter or Return, and open Levels. Make the input black level 150 and the input white level 175. Change the blend mode to screen. Changing the blend mode to screen makes the larger stars show through the smaller stars. This gives our space image a bit more depth. Let's place the two star layers into a folder. Shift-click on the stars layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command-G. Name it Stars, and reduce its opacity to 40%. The stars will look very faint, but they'll brighten later once we add the cloud filter and brush in color. Make the border layer active and reduce its fill to 0%. Reducing the fill to 0 makes whatever is inside the layer invisible, but it won't affect the layer styles that we add to the layer. They'll retain their visibility. Double-click the thumbnail of the border to open the layer style window. Click Stroke. Click the color box and pick Black. Then click OK. The size is 15 pixels and the position is inside. Click Inner Glow. Click the color box and pick White. Then click OK. Make the blend mode Linear Dodge, the opacity 20%, and the source Edge. The choke is 100%. And the size is 15 pixels. Then click OK. Make the Stars folder active and click the New Layer icon twice to make two new layers. Name the top layer Clouds and change its blend mode to Color Dodge. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Make Layer 1 active and name it Colors. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Make the size 600 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity 10%. Click the foreground color and pick a color you like as the first color you'll brush in over your stars. Then click OK. Gently brush over them. Click your foreground color again and pick another color. Feel free to brush over your other colors to create subtle gradients. Brush in as many or as little colors as you want to create an image you like. Make the Clouds layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Name it Lens Flare. Fill it with black by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Flyout list and click Black. Change its blend mode to Screen. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the brightness 125% and the lens type 50 to 300 millimeter zoom. Drag the lens flare approximately a quarter of the way down from the top and click OK. In Part 2, we'll complete our Star Wars Episode 7 poster. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.